Would you care for some more tea, sir?
No, thank you.
Dinner will be ready in a half hour. Why don't you take a little nap?
I know I'm being very difficult, but do you think we might put off dinner for tonight? I haven't much of an appetite.
But, Professor, you've got to eat something.
Perhaps later.
I could keep it warm for you. Why don't you take a little nap?
Timothy Arnold. I never thought that one would pass. I had an incorrigible habit of chewing bubble gum and then popping it. Sounded like a howitzer. Upon my soul, it sounded exactly like a howitzer. William Hood, eh? Little Bill Hood. Smallest boy ever to play varsity football here. Had a penchant for Shelley. Artie Beechcroft. Now, there was a lad. There was a staunch lad. Full of heart, that one. Was he the one that... Oh, yes. I remember now. His father wrote me a letter. He was killed at Iwo Jima. Freckle-faced little fellow. He had a most infectious grin. Never stopped grinning. The minute he walked into the classroom, he just had to smile. They all come and go like ghosts. Faces, names, smiles. Funny things they said, or sad things. Or the poignant ones. I gave them nothing. I gave them nothing at all. Poetry that left their minds the minute they themselves left. Aged slogans that were out of date when I taught them. Quotations dear to me that were meaningless to them. As a failure, Mrs. Landers, an abject, miserable failure. I walked from class to class, an old relic, teaching by rote to unhearing ears, unwilling heads. As an abject, dismal failure. I moved nobody. I motivated nobody. I left no imprint on anybody. Now, where do you suppose I ever got the idea that I was accomplishing anything? I think I'll take that nap now. And I apologize for putting off our dinner like this.
Professor Fowler! Professor Fowler!